confíen y que con la clave no han indicado que tengan los chiquín y el discurso. Aquí el saco es el go, a su saco. Gracias. Yo antes de que lo pregunte.
So now this open book exam will open a different client may have. I think from my understanding, what you want to know is actually what does the answer scheme look like, isn't it? So to answer that, my idea or my opinion is you don't prepare an answer scheme, but you prepare a marking guide. So what's the difference between answer scheme and marking guide? So answer scheme will normally be populated with the correct answer that you expect to see from the students. A marking guide will be something that what Prof. Aziz was saying just now. The students give a justification on their answer. So that means 5 marks for exploration on this topic or these points, elaboration on this point. So those kind of so we need to change the way that we write our marking scheme. I don't want to use the word marking scheme anymore, because when we go into OE, it becomes a marking guide where we guide the markers, what kind of marks that we give the students.
So this is the right term, marking guide. Okay. Alright. That's where your question is not giving. The subsections, right? That will be the key. Alright? Okay, you wanted to ask a question?
Straight or opinion?
Yeah, opinion, yeah.
Resources we allow the students to use is very important. So for example, recently I gave the students some open book quiz. Okay. So of course open book, they can also use the internet and Google everything, doesn't matter. But now with the advent of all this chatbot, it's become very dangerous. So for example, I just picked up one spectrum from the...
Why dangerous?
Because they come up with an answer that is actually very reasonable. So then it defeats the purpose of assessment. So for example, I just pick a spectrum from the internet. Then I just ask the students some questions based on that. So of course, if they were Googling, they would never find an answer. Then of course, I caught one student using the chatbot. That's me, you're not allowed to use this. But after the quiz, I asked the students to throw me the questions, and then I just want to look at the answer. Then the chatbot actually come up with a very reasonable answer. So that's why I think this time.
Is preventing them from using chatbot in the way to go?
Yeah, I think it should not be allowed in the exam, that's why.
So if you do that, then it solves our problem, isn't it?
I did not say it solves our problem. I mean, open book is okay, but you should limit the type of resources that can be used for the open book.
That I agree that we need resources. But if we are finding, just because we find a solution, prevent them from going there, they call, that's an acceptable, I don't agree with that. Because if you ask me, if they are working, they can have resources. So we are actually simulating what they will face if they are working.
So because it's the opinion, but it's like when they're working, of course they can use anything to find a solution.
Yeah.
But the purpose of assessment is actually kind of speaking, you want to differentiate the students. Which one is a good one and a bad one and things like that. But you like that. That's the purpose of assessment in the beginning. So for example, given the options, maybe everyone wants to study medicine, engineering or law. But in the end, not all students speak it because of the assessment, the cutoff.
But what we are trying to say is that if these are disruptions that we cannot stop. And you cannot prevent them from coming.
RL, some students are mixed in face to face, isn't it? So the purpose of the assessment is actually to ensure fairness. And we need to make sure that there is no unfair conditions or unfair advantage from one to another. That is, I think, more important. So if you have RL students who are doing their exams online, and then you have sitting down students who are doing their exams in the exam hall, how do you make sure, how do you write the exam questions, and how do you set the limitations for the assessment to make sure that there is no unfair advantage from one to another?
Maybe they are giving you something more than what you didn't teach, betul? Which is not wrong, correct, right?
It's good actually.
It's good. So just because you didn't teach something, it's not that they cannot write it, right? But if you expect them to give you something else, then you have to say it.
Okay. Because sometimes I have two cases. Like I have one student who goes to the very core without me being able to really say that I understood what is the exact thing that I've got them to explain. Versus someone who can say, well, how does electron work? But then doesn't really answer the question.
Then your clarity of the question is important. What do you expect from that? Clarity. I think we can clarify for you can do that, I think. Easy. Okay? So don't punish them for giving you more than what you teach them, if it is right, right?
Sure.
Yeah. Momo, you want to say something?
Yes. Some of the exams itself, usually the exam is one of the assessments. All the exams. So usually there's some other assessment like oral examinations, presentation. Sometimes you need to have a discussion with them so you can understand and make sure that he completely gets the argument. Not just the exam that he can write.
Okay,
yeah,
the focus is on exam, but he can do it with test. Okay? Alright. This one is okay, huh? What we are saying is that we don't promote. Be a little bit more complex, a little bit more difficult, a little bit more higher taxonomy. Okay? Now, this is one of the slides that I need. Now, as I said this morning, if you take these three words out, bincangkan, uraikan, itu lagi apa ya? Terangkan. Why we have to limit ourselves into this? Okay, why can't we, okay, calculate, determine, okay. Why don't we compare? Why don't we justify it? We give them answer. Okay, a person has selected this to be the main criteria to determine economic wellness in a village area. Justify the choice. You can do that, right? Confirm, adjust, ask if it is suitable, right? Ask them to justify. We don't see many of this. Now, we don't even. I've never seen anybody asking people to identify mistakes. Why not?
this is what we do in our life anyway, every time. With our husbands, with our wives, with our staffs, right? Then you come to assessment, we never use this. I don't. You see, asking them to identify mistakes and propose solution for it is one of the highest quality thinkings those things that you can ask. In fact, you can give a solution to this. Solution to this problem is this. Justify the choice using economic and social dimension for the urban dwellings. You can do that there, please a bit. What can we improve? Analyze the impact. If this is implemented wrongly, what is the impact? If this is implemented in this condition, what is the impact? If this is implemented in our neighboring country, do you think the same success can be achieved? For example, why don't we use this? How to correct it? What modification is required? So this is an idea. I've asked this question. Okay, what modification we can do so that it will be usable for okay use, you know, those challenged okay use. Something like that. What can be done? Why this was done? So these are the dimensions I hardly see in my analysis of exam questions in Europe, especially from Mars. It's only Sparanga in Chandra Murata, perspective. And the word is perspective. Apoka perspective. Yes, I agree. Use this. All these things are like that. Pinchakan, they don't even know what is to pinchakan at that time. I've spoken with students who are afraid to come and see me as an HEB. Show me the questions, pinchakan, you don't know. Then I'm marking. Kawandi answers same thing, he also answers same thing. One will get me, another will get me plus. So, like that. So these are some of the items that you can familiarize yourself with. Now I have some papers. I'm going to show you. You can comment. I'll go through probably bullet points. So these are my, okay, the reason one is that it's all test, but actually it's an exam because this is for PhD.
give them under and look at this mistake and grab or whatever, start my mouth. This is for that, I don't have to do anything. So easier for me my mouth. So I cut marks. If nothing given minus 5, which 5 marks, right? If something is given, then in my mind I give them all minimum 3, whatever you write, throw, I give them 3. So I just have to see at the 4 or 5. 4 very good, 5 less. So the marking strategy is also important. I start from 100. So at the end of the day, I see minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 5. If you don't answer minus 5, if you answer very wrongly, what you do, so you improve, well, so maybe. Okay, one, I show one example. Another question. Next one. Many go make them busy, we cannot go unless we know the location. Unless we know where to look for resources. Here I have a module. Create a module for them. We have people to run the resources. Okay? Seven. So when I went for moderation, I learned the moderator. The moderator says that this is not answer. I say that. No, because you never go through the student has been taught, student has been trained. So student for student is okay, but for a moderator who has not want to do that something. Maybe my brother pulls so around with the other Susan. Susan can be done. So it's a context of the students in what we give them. We give them all the resources they have hope for them to be fun. Right? So we have been trained for this. Okay, so these are okay, the final one is. So all this this used to be a very popular subject. Very popular subject among the students. But this was actually an elective subject. And they made it compulsory with them. This is how to write a blog. Okay, so to look it also. Okay, this one is an interpretation. Maybe you all can actually interpretation. This one would be that this can be open book or not? What do you think? What is your comment? Is that what is your comment? What's your comment? You will look at popular 17, okay. Popular, you will look at 17. Put that time here. Okay, 16. What's your comment? This 120, the last paper, 120. drive our exam quality requirement and quantity. That is something for us to something to apply to finish. But we cannot make that as a reason to not do it.
I think my opinion is I think we are lucky, isn't it? And maybe at the first time that we try book, yes, it is a bit of a struggle to sort of synthesize what students are answering and how that matches into our marking guides. But either way, we are still marking. Even if we have 130 students with conventional exam, using the normal scheme, compared to 120 students using the marking guide, the time difference, to me, my personal opinion, will not be that much different. Maybe you would add probably 1 hour or 2 hours to the overall time that you are going to mark. But yeah, that's about it. It's not going to be too much.
The question here is, this time around, for example, one week, she has got 4 subjects to mark. So 120, 40, 30, 20 here. Yeah. So there are so many papers. So how do we mark that one week?
How?
happening impacts household income. Household income. This is 25 marks to be thrown into students. So is this a suitable question? Number 27, 27. 27. Is it a suitable question? Suitable question.
For open book.
Open book. For a course called fictitious called family income in the second year. Useful for anything economic at least. lesser than the time that it takes to type the questions, am I right?
And I think you can really generate the response and it will come up with a new answer. Let's do that.
This is what we are talking about now. So now, even that was there, doesn't stand so now, if you look at this here, if this is the answer, how you can use this answer to ask for questions? Example, what are the challenges that you can have to implement this? For example, right? So that can be. So now, if you don't know these technologies, you've been thinking that the students are producing fantastic work for you. That can be my opinion. In fact, they take this, they go to Google Translator, they translate, they give you a person like you. Nice person are you, and you won't even know. And about something else, what do you got?
GPT can do person like you.
GPT can do person
like
you,
but it's like, it's person like you jump in this.
They are not there yet. Okay? Talking is what? mechanics students, you have to prepare them early. Don't give them open book at the end. Okay? Next one. Marking, yes, I think we have already discussed this. Next one. Quality control. Okay, the biggest worry is cheating. Even close book, the biggest worry is cheating. So, that's so. What if you do questions properly? Or like what we say that we still control the classroom conditions. Okay, it can be done. Okay, next. Resources, hybrid, when you mentioned about hybrid. Bit more difficult, but you can keep them early. Like myself, I keep them early. How my open book will look like? Train them. Yeah, next. Now, this is okay. Okay, I had something that we do. Why don't we go to my slide? I show one example from the something that we took from the internet. From my internet. This is from your computer. Check my time. Computer for my time. Simply PDF.
Oh, you can hear.
Okay. Just comment on this. Okay, see these questions anyone, everyone? You are finishing anyway. Okay, now dengan merujuk kepada satu teori perbandaran bincangkan kekuasaan persekitaran bandar. Do you think this is good enough for open book? Bincangkan bandar sebagai satu ekosistem dengan merujuk perbandaran yang open book, maybe. Okay, but this is easily copyable. You can ask chatbot and criticism.
Yeah.
Okay.
Get it now.
Okay. Pencemaran udara bandar disebabkan oleh perubahan fisika bandar. All this chat can answer in no time. Maybe we try this solar. Bincangkan bandar sebagai satu ekosistem. Discuss the town as an ecosystem. Okay. Do I need to
change my cost performance, no need, right? No need. What are the advantages? We spoke about it. You must read that. What resources are required? Okay, there are resources that are required. What skills are required? You have a PhD, you like teaching, you are new teaching, that's already a qualification. No one is an expert. Maybe what I say, many of you may not agree. You may not do what I tell you because
who can assist me? You assist yourself. Actually, there is somebody can assist or something that can assist you now. So let's go back to ChatGPT. And I tried. So this is actually a real question that my colleague in the faculty asked me to. She asked me to help her with setting up the question for other students. So she gave me this question for me to test. So these are on real estate. So it says management of occupancy cost can increase organization learning overall performance, elaborate on the cost benefit. So it's not really an open book type thing, but I put it in and automatically actually comes up with this answer. It shows to her that actually the system can actually answer question and according to her, I think it says it's 60% correct. So that is not, it's not 100% correct, it's still 60% correct. So I asked the ChatGPT to elaborate more. So I asked what are the drivers for the two costs. Then it starts to bring in or bring up the answer to about 80% to be correct. So the next thing that I asked ChatGPT to actually help us convert this question into a book exam. So, and this is why I did this morning. So, it comes up with actually something that is quite similar to the original question. So, I asked the chatbot again, this is too simple. Can you expand it with a specific content? You employ this chatbot to put your message in, isn't it? And then it comes up with this, what I would think is actually a good way to ask the question, isn't it? And we can actually still polish this. Okay, so now it comes up with a scenario that says, imagine you are a real estate manager for a real estate with multiple locations.
What I would say is not, yeah.
So it becomes a more nuanced question, I would say. So, and then I ask it again. I want to provide at least three scenarios for the students to choose so that there are more varieties in answer. So it comes up with this. So choose one of the following scenarios. Retention is very decline in sales. So these are the things that will actually, it will not become something that you can actually just Google, isn't it? It becomes something that students need to think about it, think critically, and answer within the context. So, we have somebody now to actually assist us to start our journey into open book question. And you don't have to call Prof. Aziz at 11 o'clock in the afternoon every day. So then you have 30 people here calling Prof. Aziz at 11 o'clock in the night. So can you look at my question whether it's open book enough or not? So you can use the now what we are still calling the enemy to actually help us. And I think this is something that we can start to think about, start to play with ChatGPT in a way that it actually helps us to do our work. And of course, we don't have to copy-paste everything. We can actually give it more context, or give it change the questions so that then it matches the context for our students. That's your assistant.
Yeah, you go back, finish it off. Okay, so you assist yourself, then there are also somebody who can assist you now. Why are you going to do this? I think this is probably will help PNL as well. What's wrong with the current method? Nothing wrong, but this is a continuous improvement. Okay?
have to change my current teaching method? No, we are talking about assessment, but more open, prepare them. When do I start? Supposed to be yesterday. How do I start today? Who else is doing it? Lots of people are doing it. Okay, otherwise, we'll be left behind. The chat is now. Many people are already doing it. There are people support group now. Okay? Will students accept this? They will accept. From my experience, they will accept this. As long as you know, you tell them, you educate them, you tell them what you expect. Okay, this is our conclusion. Closed book examination is no longer the only option to assess students' learning. The well-designed open book examination is the way to go. Test students understand their complex problem solving activity. One should consider open book as an option to assess students. Okay, right now we see as the instrument has last for 5 years. 5 years. Start doing it now. You may have got a book in it, but start doing it again. Next one. Okay. Main take-home points. Anybody wants to say some main take-home points? Good, bad? Are you more knowledgeable in this than you came into this? Or you are more confused now? How about yourself? Okay.
can even minus mark for wrong reasons.
Yeah.